So today's video tutorial, we're going to look at running mechanics. So running is a skill and it needs to be coached. You can't just expect someone to go out and run and be efficient and have correct mechanics. We've got to teach them certain things. So we're going to look at foot contact, where we should contact the floor, what part of our foot should contact the floor, that stiffness through the ankle, and show you some drills to create that and get a bit more reactive. Correct angles and joint angles, and forward leans, etc., because we're going to be looking at acceleration, because in basketball we won't ever reach our top speed, and we'll always be accelerating or decelerating. And this video is just going to be looking at straight line speed, so we're not going to touch on the change direction stuff. That's for another video. But yeah, and we'll look at the arm movements and everything as well. So the first thing we'll look at is foot contact. Okay, so we're going to look at foot contact. For the purpose of these drills, I've just taken my shoes off. Obviously, when you're running the drills, you won't do it with your shoes on, just so you can get a better idea of the emphasis of what I'm looking at. Okay, so when we're running, we want to focus on some what we call dorsiflexion. Okay, so that's having a nice stiff ankle, that's moving your toes up. Okay, so we've got plantar flexion, we move our toes down, move our toes up, it's dorsiflexion. Okay, if we can get good dorsiflexion, we're gonna create a nice stiff ankle. Okay, we're not gonna have any energy leaks when we're running. Okay, we're gonna create a good solid force through the ground, through our stiff ankle, creating up through the body. Now we look at our foot contact. Where do we want our foot to contact the ground in relation to our body? Well, we want under the hip. Okay, so if our foot contact's under the hip, we're gonna create vertical force. Okay. And then we're going to convert that into horizontal force as well, because we're going to be moving horizontally. Alright, so we can create good lines of force production, alright, so we can get faster. Okay, we're going to touch on arm movement in a little bit, but right now we're looking at foot placements. Okay, so don't worry about my arms for now, alright. So first things first, contact on the midfoot or the ball of the foot, okay. So we're just going to teach the athlete how to do that. So very simple drill, show you from the side. Just flex your toe and slam it down into the floor. Okay, flex the toe, slam it down. And we can do this. Okay, we can do a movement. So flex the toe, slam it down with the ball of the foot. Keep the leg straight. Under our hips. Okay? Flex the toe. Slam it down. Okay, add a bit of velocity to that. A bit faster. So straight arm, straight leg up. Don't run out. So people tend to go out, everything's in a straight line. Okay, so up, flex the toe, contact under the hip, but we start slow. When they're solid at that, we can then go straight legs. And then we're going to progress that into a more, what you look at as running, because right now we don't run with straight legs, we're just bringing our knees up in the swing phase, okay? So we're going to progress to that. But now we're going to look at our arm movements. Okay, so when we're running, we want nice solid arm movements, okay? So essentially we're gonna keep our arm locked at 90 degrees. We don't want our arm movement through the elbow, went through the shoulder. Okay, so a nice coaching cue is we're gonna take something out of our pocket, bring it to our hip. And as you can see, I'm moving through my shoulder, not my elbow. Okay, and then when we're moving with our arms, we don't wanna come across our body because that's gonna cause rotation. And again, we want straight line, no energy leaks whatsoever. So we're here. There. Nice and simple. So you can get your athlete just to do that, pocket to ear. Not this, but through the shoulder, pocket to ear, pocket to ear. Get some drills, really, really simple drills you can have. You want to create some good solid force. So if we're moving our arms quick, through the back kinetic chain, we're going to have quicker movement through our legs. Okay, so if we're going to move our arms nice and quick, it's going to transfer into running faster. We're going to have someone hold their hands behind and hit their hands. So we know if we're missing the hands, we're coming across the body. So if we're not hitting the hands behind us, we're going side to side. Straight line, back and forth. Okay, really simple. Again, movement through the shoulder. To get the idea of the athletes actually moving their arms fast, and the type of momentum it can cause, we'll get them sitting down here, up, and then they just go like this, forward and back, start moving faster, and as you can see, that's creating a more momentum through my hips, and I'm starting to bounce up and down. So try and get the athletes to bounce. Just like that, okay? Looks a bit silly, but it's a bit of fun, and it's a really good coaching cue, okay? So, pocket to hip. All right, and then we're gonna combine that in the next drill with our foot movement. Okay, so I put the shoes back on, because now we're gonna actually do some stuff that looks a bit more lap running, okay? So, we're gonna start doing some simple drills, little skips, a little bit of rhythm, working on our foot contact and our arm movement together, okay? Essentially, from the side. When we drive up on here, we want a nice flex, dorsiflex toe, okay, up, and we're contacting under the hip, just like I mentioned before. Okay, so if one of our knees is up, the opposite arm is up. Okay, so it's not much, just like that. Okay, so very simple drill, literally just simple marching. Okay, so we're up. Just nice and simple, keeping the elbows locked. And stamping through the floor, remember, dorsiflex, toe, contact under the hip. Okay, very simple marching. Don't progress this if they can't do it, because we're not going to get anywhere. Okay, they've got to be able to do this, nice and simple. Upright torso, simple marching. Okay, and we can add a bit of rhythm to that when they're getting good. Okay, so just a little bit quicker, a little bit of rhythm. So we're again, driving the knee up, stamping down. Add a little bounce, get a bit of a reactive element. So. Okay, so a little bounce on the top, bringing it up, bringing the knee up. Okay, so we're bouncing. Alright, nice and simple. Get those go, and then we'll move on to some more complex drills next. Okay, so we've done some simple skips. We're looking at ankle stiffness, good foot contact under the hip. Okay, so I'm going to throw in a little drill called pogos. Okay, really simple drill to work on that ankle stiffness and contact. Alright, so if someone's struggling to get nice solid foot contact, they're coming out on the side, ankles rolling, you know, we want to correct that and get stiff through the ankle. So simple pogo, it's just a little pogo jump, alright? So we're going to jump up, flex the toe. Slam it into the floor. Okay? Jump up, flex the toe. Slam it into the floor. It's very simple. Doing jump rope with this sort of foot action is really beneficial. Okay? Or flex up. Okay? That's helping the athlete learn how to get stiffness through his ankle, and then we can translate that into the skipping. You know what I mean? Into the skipping. I'll show you. So, into the skipping here. Nice, solid foot contact, all right? So we've got that, all right? But as we're looking at acceleration, we're not gonna be running up in an upright position, because when we accelerate, we'll be leaning forward, all right? So the next thing I'm gonna show you is how to create that foot contact in a more realistic situation, so we create correct angles, okay? So we're gonna need a wall for this, all right? So I'll show you that next. We're going to use this wall to create an angle as if we're replicating our acceleration pattern up here. So the angle we're looking for is 45 degrees, alright? So we position our body 45 degrees. So we're there, nice and straight body, we don't want our back sinking in, our hips falling through. Nice and straight line with our arms up against the wall, right, at our 45 degree angle. Okay, then we're going to bring up one leg, and flex the toe in towards me and stamp it into the floor, staying upright. Okay, and then we can replicate that with two. So on command, okay. Now you should have seen there, as I pulled that up, I crept down. So you want to avoid that, right? So nice and stiff here, okay. And then we can try three. Okay, again, trying to avoid rounding the back, get that 45 degree angle there. And getting the athlete used to holding those positions, getting the strength to hold those positions. Knee up, toe up, drive through, under the hip. Remember, 45 degree angle, we're driving through under the hip. Straight line force coming through. Okay, so that's a wall drill we can do. So, essentially, we've learned how to have a good foot contact, We've got the pogo drills, simple arm movements to go along with the knee movements. Going to skipping, add a bit of a rhythm to the skipping, and now we're looking at our accelerations. Okay, so we're using the wall to help with that. So we're progressing to the wall drill. All right. Once we progress into the wall drill, we can then take the wall out of the equation and accelerate through in a straight line, which I'll show you next. We've done the wall drill, so now we're gonna take the wall out of the equation and do some straight line running. Okay. So we've progressed our athlete to a point now where we're comfortable with them doing some straight line running with correct technique. Okay, it's very, very simple. We're just gonna have our feet together, okay? We're just gonna allow our body to fall forward. And as you get to that point where you feel like you've got to step through, that's pretty much 45 degrees, okay? So if I do it again, we fall forward, I've got to step through, okay? As I'm falling forward, I'm gonna drive that knee up, okay? So when we go back to the wall drill here, that's that position there. So when I'm falling forward, drive that knee up and come through. I'll show you one more time and then I'll get a different angle in the camera so you can see. So over here, fall forward, drive that knee up and go through. All right, let's get different angles so you can see what that looks like. Okay, so you change the angle now so you can see three or four steps in a row. Okay, so reminder of the drill, we're just gonna fall forward, drive that knee up and sprint through, okay? Not forgetting our foot contact under the hip, drive the knee up, arm movements too, alright? So, nice and simple. Okay, really simple drill. You get your athlete to do 5 meters and then coast out, okay? Again, emphasis on forward foot, driving the knee up, solid foot contact, 2 or 3 hard steps with correct arm movement, and then coast through. Okay, so we piece together a nice little run mechanic session. Okay, so we've started with simple foot contact, get the athlete to understand the simple foot contact, then progress it into bringing the knee up, getting it underneath the hip. Adding in arm movement, locked at the elbow, pocket to ear, moving through the shoulder. Okay. Then looking at acceleration, so 45 degree angle, driving through, big knee drive, stamp on the floor, underneath the hip, and then create linear speed. So we're now looking at falling forward, which was the last drill I showed you, driving through, going through, and then we can start getting a little bit creative. We're going to have some braces. Along the distance, they're sprinting. Again, in basketball, you're rarely going to sprint from maybe free throw line to free throw line. So, what's that, 15 meters, maybe 20 meters tops, before you have to change direction. All right? So, it's all about acceleration, creating the right angles, getting out of blocks essentially. All right? And then you can look at different start positions. Okay, so you have a 2-point start here. Again, forward lean, nice and strong. Drive through, coming through. I'll show you that in real time. So we're down here, 2 points up there, boom, drive through. And legs up, all right? So everything we're looking at, same angles, repetitive, coaching cues that continually point at the right things, okay? So 45 degree angle, knee drive, foot on the hip, arm movements, alright? So you can review those and add straight line sprinting into your part of your warm up. So you can put something together for your warm ups, 5-10 minutes, working on these drills every single day. The top sprinters in the world do these drills every single day. Repetition, it'll be perfect. Okay? So if we can create straight line speed, it's going to help our athletes get out on the break, recover on defense. Those sort of things. In a later video, we'll look at changing directions, okay? Because it's just straight line speed, very simple drills. Good luck there. As always, give me a shout. Emails down there. Check out the website. I'm happy to answer any questions. Feedback's always welcome. Some stuff on social media as well. At Do Training, if you want to contact me through that. Hopefully this is beneficial for you and your athletes. And look forward to sharing that video with you soon.